Tell the people what you got going on in your life. What's that from?
Suffering.
Gabby's working the night shift. Oh my gosh, guys. Look at outside. There it is. Fall time is coming. Oops. Actually, fall is pretty much here, right? Yeah. So that means it's time for sweatshirts, some cozy sweatpants, some nice warm lifts, some crisp air driving to the gym, pre-workout. Oh my gosh, it's actually gonna be a magical time. Gabby has to work, she has to work all night at the hospital. So she goes from 7 p.m. to 7 a.m. So that's pretty brutal. But I get to work out. All right, well, today we're gonna be doing a push day. So, yeah, it's gonna be, Gabby was making fun of my shoulders today, so I might have to double up on shoulders today. Today's main focus is gonna be chest and kind of shoulders secondary to that, because I'm trying to really get like my chest big, but yeah, basically the way I have my push day set up is the first day of the week is more like shoulder dominant. And now that I'm kind of been getting into strength lifts a little bit more, like the deadlift and squat. So yeah, you guys saw the 405 high bar squat with Adam. If you didn't see that, go check out that video. But, the 405 high bar squat went really well. And I was like, damn, I'm actually pretty strong and I'm not very heavy right now. Like not as heavy as I normally am when I'm like doing strength lifts. So that was like pretty nice. And also the pull day after that, so I did like a little deadlift day and I managed to do 545 for 5 reps in sumo and like RP like 8.5. So it like wasn't too bad. The weight was like flying. So that was like the first time I did sumo in like a really long time. And I'm really surprised that I actually hit 545 for 5. Cause like, yeah, that was like, I think I hit that once when I was like I maybe hit 555 for 4 while I was in like really good training, but this was just like back nice and recovered, you know, just my back was a little sore from squats, but I just slung the weight. I didn't take any like strong stimulants, just regular pre-workout day. And I managed to pull some weight, which is pretty nice. But yeah, so I'm gonna start doing some more compounds, it looks like, cause I'm having so much fun with it. And I just like, I find myself craving that next deadlift day or craving that next squat day. So yeah, tomorrow I'm gonna be squatting, but today is gonna be push. I'm gonna be working on my physique a little bit, blowing up the shoulders, blowing up the chest, trying to get a good focus workout. This is what we got for the fit today. Hold on. Hold up, I'm gonna get this right. You know what, whatever. But I got the black sweatshirt on, the Dreamer Set sweatpants, all Young LA, but yeah, we're gonna head to the gym now. You know, Arizona is a desert, but it has the most pretty skies, like, out of everywhere I've traveled, except for maybe, like, sunset wild. I don't know, it's hard to beat. All right, you guys, so I know I've been doing, like, a lot of, like, I guess workout videos with people, and sometimes it can be easier to do workout videos with people just because, you know, they can help you record. I don't have a cameraman or anything like that, so, you know, it's kind of nice when I don't have to, like, set up the camera. So usually when I go record by myself, I try to go like not at peak hours. It's about 6 o'clock right now, so hopefully people are just leaving the gym. Some kid came up to me and he was like, would you still be like working out, and like, you know, does it get hard to like work out and like keep your physique up? And I responded to that with, you know, if I wasn't doing any of this social media shit, and I wasn't doing YouTube and I wasn't doing any of that, I would still 100% be in the gym, because I don't go into the gym, like, yes, I want to look good, yes, like, I care about my physique, and, you know, I want to, like, create something really impressive that I love, but really, what I value the most about the gym is how I am not thinking about anything else, how I'm able to exert extra energy that I have, or shit that I just want to, you know, I just got to blow off, or, you know, really anything like that. And I take that time in the gym as like a very solid, like, I guess solitary, like,
quiet time for myself just to like let loose and truly be myself and truly let loose. That's why, like in my last video or two videos ago, there's some guy like constantly shaking his head, like, me and my buddy are going to failure on squats, like we're really pushing hard. And you know, he's looking around, he's worried about us. And you know, it's a shame to have people like that in the gym, because you know, as a place that I want to feel safe in and where I want to feel like most comfortable, like being judged and feeling like that is honestly the worst thing ever. That's why it's like important for you to have like a good gym environment, you know, just so you can, you don't have to feel like that. But back to that guy who was talking to me, and he was like, does it get like hard to like come and work out? And I'm like, no, this is actually the part that I really truly love, you know. I want to through my videos and stuff, I want to show you guys like what I'm talking about right now. Essentially, is like, you can go in the gym and really, you know, enjoy yourself and have a great quiet time just in your own world. And you know, sometimes when you're so caught up in the outside world and just like everything going on, like it takes a lot out of a person. And for us, you know, we're constantly consuming so much media, so much everything, like whatever, TikTok news, whatever. We're seeing messed up stuff on the internet all the time, and it's just like it's constantly like knocking on our metaphorical doors. And you know, sometimes that can be overwhelming. It can't be a normal thing, you know, like it's like very recent. It's like people in ancient civilizations aren't like hearing about stuff that's going on the opposite side of the world, you know. So but even if you're not like looking at the news or anything like that, like shit that's going on at school, shit that's going on at home, you know, it can be tough sometimes. And when you have a place where you can, you know, escape and hop in your buddy's car or go drive yourself to the gym and not think about anything, like literally, like it's not even in your mind at all, it's like, that's something you should really value. Because you know, there's not many things that are beneficial that help to take your mind off things. And like video games, for instance, like I have somewhat of a, you know, video game addiction. And you know, it's not the best thing for me, because you know, I put off all my things I'm supposed to be doing, and you know, I let myself relax and I let myself enter that world. And you know, you could take that even a step further. And you know, people who use alcohol or you know, drugs to help escape, you know, that's not a healthy thing. And that's not gonna, like, that's, you know, when you get back out, your problems aren't gonna be better, you're not gonna be thinking clear. And what I found was with the gym, that's like the one place where like I notice a slight difference, is like I can go there to escape from everything, and I can come out like motivated with a clear head and feel invigorated, and to go do my shit that I gotta do, or any stress that was like kind of bothering me before, you know, it doesn't seem as bad. And you know, once I like really like thought about this, and you wanna look at the things in your life and you know, really be grateful for what you have. And once I like realized that the gym was doing that for me, I was like, dude, I wanna show you guys this stuff. And so for me, going to the gym, it's not a discipline motivation thing. It's just like, I go if I'm feeling like shit and it makes me happy, and that's why I do it. And you know, the gym might not do that for you, because you might not have that passion towards it or whatever. But find something in your life that, you know, whether it's playing an instrument, whether it's going on a walk with your dog, or whether it's, you know, going on hiking and taking, you know, taking pictures of nature, or, you know, just appreciating the beauty of the world, or whatever it may be. But, you know, if you find just something that helps take the edge off of life a little bit, that's not gonna cause more problems and add more problems to that pile, then you'll be like a lot happier, you know. Oh, sorry, the light wasn't on when I was talking. Also, one last thing, don't be afraid to be really hard on yourself and like yell at yourself or whatever, and don't be too hard on yourself at the same time. So, because I know, you know, I know there's like so many different types of people out there. I'm just trying to speak to everyone. But I know myself, you know, I would really get on myself about just simply like pushing myself. Like, I'm not pushing myself hard enough in the gym. And before the gym, I would watch those old Machiavelli motivation videos about like, you ain't shit. Like, you ain't, like, just pretty much bringing myself, like, basically making myself realize that there are people who, you know, work their ass off for this shit. And it's like, if you really want it, you got to be willing to push yourself like that. And if you're not willing, then there's no point in beating yourself up about it and comparing yourself to others. Because, you know, very common quote, comparison is the thief of joy. But, you know, if you truly believe in yourself that you can make it, and, you know, you will, you know, be hard on yourself, and you will be forcing yourself to do those things, there's going to be no one else there to, you know, force you to do these things. It's simply up to you. And, you know, if you want something and you're going to regret not doing it, do it. And if you, it's like, it's not that big of a deal, it's not going to like take a piece of you with you not doing that thing, then it's probably not going to be that important and you probably don't need to do it. But today we're going to be using the wired headphones, all reliable, just because that's just how I'm feeling today. I remember when I first got these working out, not these exact ones, I probably lost the exact ones, but these actually might be them. I don't know, but I remember like when these ones came out, because you know how the Apple headphones used to be like a lot different. They had like the auxiliary cord jack. But when they switched to these, I was like, let's go, baby. Because you had to use the adapters and shit. These are the best. But, then AirPods came out. And those are great. Just frustrating sometimes. But we need consistent and reliable today. So we're using this. This is a war. Spark the fight or flight response. Slam the orange juice. Eat a steak after. I think that's the plan. Alright, you guys, so after that, it's probably been like an hour and a half since I had that little bit of rice, like that bowl of rice and that orange juice, and now I have a lot more rice now and a little bit of beef and some clam chowder that we have. So I'm gonna eat all that, and yeah, then probably be put to bed after that. So yeah, see you guys.